back to Let's Play Obscure, my Halloween special. I am Classic Gamer, and last time, well, we got to the parking lot. No, I don't want to do that. And we are about to enter the auditorium. Now, before we unlock this van, I don't know whether or not if you do this now, apparently some monsters appear. I think if I do it... Oh, actually, I've already done it. Okay. Right, what we want to do, we want to go into the auditorium and, see what's in here. Oh, this, nice. Oh, and some tape, even better.
Old photos? Friedman. Man hasn't aged a bit.
So apparently, Freeman is in all of the pictures, but yet he hasn't aged one bit in however long. Now that is one scary looking statue, and is actually a feature, I believe, on the in the front cover of the game. Well, it basically shows sort of like torment and stuff like that. Let's go up here though. So apparently there's a basement in the under here. We can get through here. Oh shit,
you're gonna love this. Come on.
Ah, I need to lower it. Damn. Oh, idiot. I should know I shouldn't have done this yet.
We need to lower the screen so we can watch the movie.
Yep, we need to lower the screen so we can watch the movie. Is there bullets over there? I think there are. Yes, bullets for the shotgun. Do well. I don't think I actually knew that. Right, out we go this way. Down into the auditorium. I'm hoping that I can, obviously I'm doing this before Halloween, but this will be done before I start 8. So 8 will probably already be, well, 8 probably won't be up
it's
until,
too quiet in here.
Yeah, this place gives me the creeps.
I think I decided to do 8 beginning with the start of November, but I'm probably going to bring that forward now I think about it. Reason being is that there's no point, you know, having a gap, so...
Testing, 1, 2, mic check, 1, 2, 3.
This music is so creepy, but it's so good for what it is. Now, I believe there's there's a medikit up here. Anything else? Oh, sticky tape. What's sticky tape? What's that? Oh, okay. Anything under here? Obscure 2. Now, you guys probably wondering, would I do that? The answer is yes, most likely. However, I am actually stuck on the last boss. So, I know how you do it, and I have done it in the past. It's just a question of getting it done. Really? Just need to double check something. Yeah, I am recording. Good. I'm using XSplit, guys. Basically, I haven't really used XSplit before. Not really to do what I'm doing now. Now we need to go up here. I think we're about to get a code from this real film that we've got. Does that guy look familiar? Oh my fucking god. What the fuck's up with that, huh? Well, I'm afraid that's something that we have to wait and see. Now, we need to go back down to the auditorium. Music keeps on starting.
This should be no problem for me. I got this. I can pick this thing.
And lo and behold, we are in. What's behind door number one? This door seems to be locked. Okay, so what's up here?
This should be no problem for me.
Good job of all staying with me. Otherwise, you would have had to go around the other side. For your safety, please make sure that the service elevator is turned on. For your safety, make sure that the service elevator is turned off after use. That basically means,
yo, what is this thing?
Oh, it looks like a plank stand, but I could be wrong. Safety. Safety off, safety on. And that allows you to go up. And like I said, you want to put the safety on when you go back down. Trust me. What the fuck is that? Yeah, they're keeping some freaky fucked up things in this school. Now, don't go anywhere near this thing because it will kill you. But time, motherfuckers. Get out of the way, Ashley.
What the hell is that?
Well, that thing was something quite fucked up. Now, believe me when I tell you, do this. You don't do that, bad things happen to people. And with that, we can go back down the ladder. And now that the elevator is stuck at the top, we can go down the ladder that's in here. Now, if you take the safety off and you try to go down, the elevator will fall and will kill someone who goes down the shaft with you. You don't want to do that. You want to make sure it is on, like so. So, we're going to save the game. And here Josh and the others arrive. See, that keeps the elevator falling. But luckily, if people are with the safety on, everyone gets out okay.
Crap! Now we can't get back up.
Aha! Look at that. It's another torch. A very powered torch. So what we're going to do, we're going to remove that. And we're going to tape the new torch to the shotgun. And then we're going to tape this one to this gun. And we're going to have this weapon on us for a little bit. And we'll give the old pistol. Let's venture into the depths of the underground.
Oh man, what kind of place is this?
Now this place can be a maze, so just be aware that you can get lost or shit. Oh yeah, take that, little fuckers. Energy drink there, you want that? It can recover your health, just a tad. I'm not actually sure where I need to go. A shotgun! And if you... If you're reading this letter, you've probably been, as I did, locked up by Herbert Freeman. I can't get out, and you might be luckier than me. I'm afraid I will soon be used as a guinea pig like all the other students. If I do get out, I have put together in a safe, hidden in the dormitory, all the proof necessary to bring down Freeman. Find the... Right, this bit here, you might want your shotgun, and what I'm going to do, I'm going to take this off here, I'm going to put the, oh damn it, shit, right, we'll give Ashley the shotgun. Save the game, as this bit could be.
You got it, buddy. It's all been saved.
Difficult if you don't prepare yourself for it. Actually, this is exactly what we need to do, because what we do is when we actually get out of here, that lever is what I was looking for in my first playthrough. Yeah, remember those big things in the start of the game, people? Well, We're about to fight one. And trust me when I say this, use the fucking shotgun. You can beat them by pistols, but it won't be as effective as the shotgun. No!
Ashley!
Crap! I was hoping that none of my people would die. Right, I'm gonna have to load this, I think.
I'm right behind you. Fine. I'll stay here.
No. 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 Yeah, that'll calm me down.
Ah, not so cocky now, are you, right? This is one useful weapon you have just picked up there, people. That is a light grenade, or better known as a flash grenade.
Never felt better in my life.
Trust me when I say this. I'm here, Ashley.
I feel great now.
Right, then when we go out, we will be able to. I think we get ambushed by three of them. So I'm gonna quit the run. Yeah, I am leaving without you. And what?
What in the hell? There are no locks left.
Done it. That's exactly what I need to do, because those two fuck you up if you don't prepare yourself for it.
Let's go.
This bit here is exactly what we do. We don't actually. Oh fuck, no.
Check it out.
First aid. Leonard seems to have handled the treatment reasonably well. No special symptoms. After a few days, his skin is covered with a melanoma. The tumours are mesmerising very much. Well, I can't read that word. But their large number is causing a worsening in his general condition. The hypersensitivity of the skin to the UV radiation as a first liaisons resulting from this are similar to that word and that word are an inherited illness. This illness is due to the mutation of genes that process against skin cancers. But in theory, this illness is that word. Henceforth, Leonard will protect himself from the sun, but the damage is done. A light rays have caused an accurate reaction in the that word gene inserted into his system. We do not foresee this because our previous guinea pigs remain in their cages. At present, the entire surface of Leonard's skin is suffering profound mutations. The mutations appear to have slowed down. They are, however, spectacular. I ask myself how he can survive in this condition. The wounds have transformed into scabs that look as though they will remain like the bark of a tree. The damage from his skeleton and his, that word, appears irreversible. His temporal lobes and his upper members are most affected parts. His condition has stabilized. His mental condition concerns me as much as the appearance he has taken on. If human appearance can be still spoken of, in his case, the only hope to cure him is now to have a gene, a guinea pig, who have suffered in the same way. In order to test the theory aimed at eradicating the gene and returning the subject to his intended initial condition. Research is very long. I will not live long enough to achieve my goal unless I inject myself with treatment and remain in the shadows until the serum is dissolved. And that's exactly what Herbert did, because his brother was obviously injected with this thing, and we just put that on there and it reveals a ladder.
No, I did it.
What's behind, or what's down ladder number one? I think we need to go in this door. Yes, this is it, we got it.
Kenny!
Get me out of here. Friedman's on his way.
You alright? You look messed up.
I'll be better once I'm out of here. Come on, hurry up!
I got a plan.
It's Friedman! Crap!
So you've been captured too. I see some cutters that could come in handy once we find a way out of here.
Well.
Yo, what is this thing?
We've now been captured, all our weapons have been taken. But, look what we've got here.
It's not doing anything.
So, we've got a hook that's conveniently in our cage, and look, there's a camera that's up there, of course. Now let's use the hook, or the rod with the hook, and boom! Cage is open!
Yo, Kenny, you alright, man? We gotta move out of here now.
Gave us injections of that stuff. If the light hits us, we'll be transformed.
Don't worry about it, man. I'll fix everything. I got cutters. Let's go search the rooms.
Infirmary. We've got to see Wixen.
She's nuts.
There's
I don't
no
trust
choice.
Her.
We only have till sunrise. After that, we're done for.
All the others are here, but obviously there's no acknowledgement that they're here at all. So what we want to do...
Let's go.
Okay, I'll go with you.
With these cutters, we can open up all the big padlocks.
Okay, so we've now got all the weapons. So we want to give Stan that. We want to give him shotgun. We want to keep this shotgun, and we want to...
Wow, I'm ready to rock.
And I think we go out this way, if my memory just is correct. Fuck!
Like that?
Whoa, that was close. Right. Job. Save the game.
It's saved.
Along here is, of course, you might recognise it from the start of the game. Look at this ladder that was put up. Now, thing.
It's not doing anything.
We used the rod with the hook, and now we are out of the freaky tunnels and back up the top.
Out at last.
Actually, that isn't the ladder we went up to, but it certainly gets us where we need to go. We need to go to the infirmary. So the infirmary, is that a med kit? Yes, it is.
There are no locks to pick here.
And Kenny's little special feature is that he can sprint really quickly. Now, of course, remember the cutters that we got? We now can get through this gate. Okay guys, well we're going to continue this in the next video. So I'm going to thank you all for watching, and when we come back, we will continue forward.
I hope Wixon will be able to help us out.
And see if Wixon can go and help us. But that, as for now, that's it for now guys. I'm going to thank you all for watching. I'll see you soon. Next time on Let's Play Obscure, my Halloween special. Bye for now.